Okay, H5P is also a free tool, all are open source, and H5P is a tool for creation of content. You asked about the SCOM file, right? Earlier, SCOM file you can only make using the Articulate Studio, but Articulate Studio is expensive, you have to pay for it, it's a paid license. Earlier, we had Articulate in UMS. Remember using Articulate Studio, which make the SCOM file? This one allows you to make a SCOM file, like a similar to SCOM file using H5P, okay? So H5P is opensource.org, and all the content as usually can be downloaded, reused, remixed, and shared. Okay, but unlike Kahoot, this is done by developer community, so it's not going to be so fancy. I mean, the graphic and all is not. So basically what you need to do, you can use your UMS account and log in to create a free account. You create a free account using your UMS ID. You can use your UMS mail and your password. Your password, you'll have to make different password. Don't use your UMS password. Create a separate password. Huh? Anyone, okay. Anyone should be okay. I don't remember my password every time, so I have to keep on recovering it. I don't use my UMS password. Okay, should be okay. So once you have it, you can create any amounts of content. Are you all in H5P? Okay. So H5P basically doesn't have many buttons. It only has one button which says try out H5P. Once you try it out, all your data will be stored in something will be stored in your My Account button. Everything is stored under My Accounts. Okay. So the first thing which you need to do is try out H5P. We'll try out the simplest H5P and we'll go into the more complex ones later. So the first thing you do is click try out H5P. Be patient with it because it takes time to load. Okay. So what H5P gives you is different kinds of content. You can create a quiz in H5P. You can create a heat map in H5P. You can create sequencing. You can create many things. I will go through them. We cannot cover all, but I will cover some which are relevant to you. You can do MCQ, everything. And once your H5P is ready, the reason why I'm teaching you H5P is because H5P, right, when the version 3 of UMS comes, version 3 of Smart comes out, you will have this one linked inside. H5P will be embedded inside. Smart 2, we can embed, external embed. So it's called embedding, so we can embed H5P. But once the Smart 3 comes in, H5P will be embedded inside our Smart Tree.
So
and
it means that you can just select
directly from Smart Tree. And then you can basically transfer your grade, your points. For example, the quiz you can transfer into our Smart. Currently we can't do that, we have to do it manually. But this is a very good tool not only for assessment, it's also for the content development and delivery of content. Okay, so we'll cover the simplest one, which is actually called the image hotspot. So many times we have an image of something and then we have to start labeling it. Okay. So that labeling creates, the image gets too overloaded with cognition, so cognitive load increase. So we work with the image hotspot. Okay. Click on image hotspot zone. Okay. We will try and create an image hotspot for something which you already have. Do you all have any image of your subject in your computer, like a cell biology or anything, like skeleton or orchid flower or some plant part? You have some in your PC? Make sure that the image which you use is also, this copyright, it should not be having a copyright. Okay, you can use, but don't use the one which you want to publish later in your manuscript. You can use an image of bat, and then we mark the parts. You can take an image of the map of Sabah, okay. And then we put the bats in that. Okay, I'll show you how to. Okay, now when you want to get images, right, you know the source of copyright-free images, the free? Is something known as, do you all know where you get copyright free image? You know the source, right? You can look at Pixabay. 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 Okay? Pixabay is actually having two sections, Bagayan. One is the commercial section, which is linked to Shutterstock. One is the free section, which is having millions of images. So if you look for image, for example, of bat, you will get the bat, the bat and ball. Just put bat. Fruit bat, just put fruit bat. Okay, there, you got. So you have all the fruit bat. I don't know what they are, but you get all the images of fruit bat. Now with Pixabay, you can download the image, reuse, remix. Okay, we click on any image of the bat. We click on any image, click on this image. Yeah, anyone, okay? Okay, go down, then you see. Okay, this is the most important thing. Free for commercial reuse, no attribution required. Means the author of this image has put the image there. He allows you to reuse, remix, commercialize. You can do anything. He will not sue you because it's sourced from the Pixabay. So when you want to download this image, you just click on free download. It will ask you, you can select the resolution, high resolution to low resolution, and you can download. The highest, and then you download it. Okay. So it just asks you to donate, but it's up to you. So then you have your image, so you open. So you can see your image. So this is a low resolution, you can get up to the higher resolution. Now you yourself can contribute to Pixabay, but your images, but usually the success rate is about 80% of the images get rejected because of the quality, image quality. So I have uploaded many, but usually 80% of them rejected if you didn't use a proper camera. Even if the line is wrong, if your horizon is not straight, you will be. You can try, but there are millions there. Okay, Zul, I think we show from Asniza the one. You have the map of Sabah, Ada map. You can download a map of Sabah. Okay, I want to show you how it's done. Okay, so what we do is once you have your image, right? We will just show this. You just write parts of food bat, parts of the bat. We just use a random. Parts of the fruit bat. The fruit bat. Just right. Okay. So this is your parts of the fruit bat. You add, and then you upload the image. So the image of the bat. Okay. Then I'll require your help to name the parts because I don't know. But so now we have the image of the bat inside. Now we want to label it with the parts. So what will happen? Normally you'll have to draw all the lines, right? And then you can do that. So you can edit the image, edit copyright. Usually this is a copyright free image, but you can still cite the source as Pixabay. Okay, you can click on edit copyright. If it's a copyrighted image, you have to write all this. But you have to take permission from the original content creator. So don't use copyrighted image. Usually you can write the image from the source, which is the Pixabay. You can put in all that detail later. If it's your image also, you can put in your name as well. Okay. Okay, then you have the hotspot icon, which is basically the color put on it. Usually you'll have the plus sign, you have the plus sign, minus sign. It's just an icon which will move on the image. Okay, so icon. So have you seen Wikipedia? Sometimes you move over, mouse over, and then the thing will pop up. This is similar. So that's how it's created using H5P. So you have the plus sign. Usually you just use plus, minus, times, or whatever, anything. Just click plus, minus. The color is there of the hotspot. Okay. And then you have a color, you can change it to red or put red or something. Okay, anything will be okay. Okay, now you have the image, right? You want to mark the hotspot. All you do is move the hotspot over the part. Okay, for example, you move it here and you say wing, right? What is that? Wings? Membrane, I don't know. Okay, just write wing. And then you click and then you name the hotspot. Okay, so you say hotspot, you can name Zulia. Wings, header. Header. Okay.
So you add one by one.
You add one by one. That's why you make it one. But once you make it, it's forever. It's you don't have to change it. Wings. And then pop-up content. You can create pop-up content. Okay. You can add text. Okay. Text. You can add text. And you can describe the wing in detail, which you cannot do on the image. Okay. This is the wing. The bat's wings are not made of feathers. It is made up of skin or something you just add. Okay. Just add your description. This is the wing. Okay, description. You can add a full description with formula. Okay, you can. Okay, now the next one you can also add. Save. Add item. You can add one more hotspot. Okay. In the next part, you move your hotspot to another part. Okay, you move it on your face. For example, the face. Okay, so you write face, and then you describe the face. Okay. Face. Just put face. Just put something. Description will be text. Okay. Text, or you can put files, image. Okay, you go and you download. Okay, confirm. Okay, cancel. Okay. You put text. Just put the text description of the face. So this is the face of you. Put in the description as well. Okay, and then add item. So done. There's no need to add any more item. Okay. So you add. So now you Google one video. You get a YouTube. So you Google a video YouTube of bats in flight. Bats in flight. Bats in flight. Bats in flight. Not Batman. Bats in flight. Slow motion. Get the slow motion. Okay. Bats in flight. Okay, that's the flight. Okay. Click. We extract the image out. We extract the code. Huh? Extract the copy. The code. Okay. Okay, so the next one we add hotspot. We just move it near the wing only, somewhere on the other side, the other wing. Somewhere on the, and then you click bats in flight, just put bats in flight. Okay, then pop-up content will be video. Okay, video, okay. Okay, you click the video, okay, so click on video, add file. Bat in flight. Okay, click on video and then you click the YouTube video. You can add your own video, you can click your YouTube video. Okay, and then insert, done. So that, okay, save. So remember something, after you finish all this thing, always click that I am not a robot, and then save the captcha. What is that? Captcha. Okay, save. Okay, let's see what happens. So okay, now you can see the image which will come here. Your student will not see the whole, they will see this with the hotspot. Okay, you can ask them to move, you can also convert this into a quiz using another tool. You can ask them which is the nose, then they will click and they will find, so you can score the who scored. Okay, so you click on the first, so you see the image, you click. So you'll see the descriptor here. If you want to add a full article on wings, you can add the article also, the full article as a PDF. Okay, so you can add. You can see the next one, so you see under one, which is the head. Okay, and then you can click on the last one, Zul. Okay, click on the last one. Okay, so that embed the video inside. The video will play into the picture itself. So the H5P can be used in this way to add things. Suppose you want to zoom on the face, right? You can have an additional image of the bat's face and zoom more into that. It will come as an image. Okay, so you can create the hotspot. Okay, so that's how it's done. Now comes the part about how you transfer it to Smart2. Okay, you use the embed code. Okay, go down to the image, right? And you'll see here two very small, which is called embed. Okay, embed. And that will give you the embed code. Don't change the setting for the size, because that's the size of the image in the window. So it will be too big if you change. Copy the embed code. Okay, go to Smart2. Okay. Add an activity or resource, and then you go down to, you can add either as page or you add as page or page. Okay. So just put description of bat or something, description of bat. Yes. Okay, you have to click on the embed code. You click on again HTML button always. And paste. Okay, we'll have to do this two times. Update. And this is the important one. Display description on course page. That's very, very important. Otherwise, the student will not see it in the first instance. Okay, and you need to create the page content. So this, you can create it here as well. So if the student cannot get embed, they will still get the link. So you can embed it. Just put this, the link to the content can be found at the following. And then you copy the link. The link is here, and then you give the click the URL. So go to the H5P, copy the URL, of the page, that URL, the URL of the page, copy and paste. In case they cannot find the embed code, they can still find the URL. Okay, and then everything done, appearance done, and save and return to the course. So if the everything is okay, because we. Okay, now the image is embedded in your course, in your main course. So the student can access the image directly in your course. So, okay, so they will see, if they click, they will see it inside it as well. Okay, they can zoom and then they see. So they will see everything in their class. So anytime you want to explain concept which is very hard to put on a diagram, you can use this one, this function in H5P. Okay, so that's it. Is it clear how it's done? It's very simple, but the only thing, you have to spend a lot of time first in embedding all the stuffs, the videos and whatever. But you can make a complex image of as well. Okay, so that's about it. So that's H5P tool one. There are other tools in H5P. We'll go through them one by one. So close all this one. Go to your library. So this one you can also use. Suppose you are making Asneeza is making the map of Sabah, and you want to show fruit beds of Sabah in different parts of the. You can take an original map and you can click the hotspot and you can put the map. So when you do a presentation for your proposal or whatever, you just say, oh, this is the map, so I click and these are the beds and these are what I found and whatever. You use for your, whenever your class or your, even your presentation, okay? So, okay, let's go to another type of H5P. I will go through one or two more. Okay, we go to H5P, okay. Okay, so there's one more which is called image sequencing. Okay, this is also useful. Usually when you're teaching the laboratory process or any process in the lab or in the, you always say, this one has to be done first. This is SOP part two, part three, part four. This is actually called image sequencing. So you can download some images. Zul, you have those butterfly, no? Butterfly, you have, right? So we create an image of butterfly from egg to metamorphosis, caterpillar metamorphosis, and then the butterfly, okay? So you create the image, butterfly evolution, just to butterfly, what's not evolution, is actually the life cycle, you just, okay? So it will tell the student, drag and drop the images in the correct sequence. So you get the first image, so you click the image, add. So we had the first image, which is the butterfly, is the other? Ada. Put the first is the caterpillar first. Then you put the chrysalis, the cocoon. Caterpillar. You can add information for your student. Okay? Now if you see down, right, this is, you will ask why this audio file, this is actually designed for visually disabled students. So it will say the first, it will just say the picture describes a caterpillar. What you will see is a caterpillar. We have to describe it for disabled, for visual. So H5P is designed for inclusive education. So it's having the visual. Okay, so this is where you have the audio file. Oh, the image, the next one, add under image. So you can add the next one, which is the chrysalis. The things will, that hanging thing, cocoon. And then the last one you add butterfly. Cocoon, just put cocoon or chrysalis. C-O-C-O-N. Cocoon. Or double O. Cocoon. Okay. Double C or double? One. Maybe double C, double O. Okay. Okay, and then the next one you add butterfly. Butterfly, okay. And just say, okay. Okay, done. So you have different things which you can set, behavioral and all those stuffs, but we don't go into this. Okay, so you go down. Done, Zul, I think done. So after everything is done, you save. Always click the save, otherwise you lose all your work. Okay, so the student will see these pictures in random order. It'll so usually three, I'm showing three. You can put in 50 or 60 images also, it's okay. It'll show in random order, and you just click randomly as it is one time, and then you put wrong, and then it'll say check. Then it'll tell you it's wrong. Okay, so if you try again, resume, retry, and then you play again. So you put the right order, and then you check. And then it will say you got points, okay? So this is also like a quick assessment tool in class. You can use it. So when it's linked to the smart tree, you can, these marks will can put directly into the system. It will capture the mark from here into the scores. Okay, so that's the clone content. But the more complex one in H5P, you can embed it as well. So embed, same system, you embed as page. Which one we have already? You click embed, update, and then you'll have embed code. Okay, so your embed, it'll embed into your system as well. If you give them alternative link, so page, you can find the link The link can be found here in case they can access. Save and return to course. Okay. Now. Okay. So it will embed there. Because we didn't click, you know what we missed out? We missed the display description on first course page. So if you don't click that, this one. No. If you don't click that, it will not show on the main page. And then. So once you have it, it's done. There, it's done in the system already. So the student will see it as a sequencing experiment. But you have to give instruction there. Please drag and drop is there inside already. Okay, so this is very good for processes. When you're teaching biological or any process, chemical, geological process, and you want to learn, enable the student to learn the process. It will also run in the system. Okay, now I will go. You all need a break or you all okay? Are you all okay? Everyone okay? Okay, I go into creating the more complex one, which is the SCOM file, the SCOM creation of the video file, okay? So to do this right, you need to find a video first, which is a lecture. Usually you use your own lecture video, okay? So Zul, you can find any video on anything, we have found last time we used life cycle of butterfly, right, for a demo.
Yeah.
Just find in the YouTube any video related to. First we show them the demo of the one which you create already. Okay, I'll show you. Okay, earlier we have created a lot of demos for different. Demo MBA. Okay. This is we have created videos for different situations. So this is actually a demo video. So what we have done, we have enabled this video to basically do what an assessment does. What happens in this video is the video will reach a certain point and stop, and then it will pop up a question. If the student does not give the correct answer, it will stop the video and stall. Okay. Now you can see it will tell you. It will just show you some description, everything describing the video, and then you will see a point here. Zul, you move here. Just before this, you move to just before that part. Disabled?
Yeah.
It's disabled. Okay, so this tells you some concept, and then it will ask you. So it tells you about the trade war and so on and so forth. Okay. Because Zul has disabled, so we cannot, as a student, you cannot move the video forward too fast. It lock the video into this box. So even Zul can't do it because we are seeing it as student. Okay, we reached there. And then, okay. Oh, now the video stops. It asks you a question. Trade war imposes one country, or it gives you an answer basically. You just have to tell true or false. For example, the answer may be true or false, we don't know. Okay? True, check. Okay? If it's correct, you can move forward. If it was false, it will send you back to the video again. So this is very good if you have a lecture in which you know the entire content. You have to know your entire content and the assessment points. So usually when we do our lecture, right, we know at which point we assess in the middle of the class. So we can use this as a tool. So how we do it is what we are going to show you now. So this thing will go on until here, it will have another question. You can put in as many questions as you want into the system and it will stop. Okay, let's see how we do it. Okay, we just close that and then we move it up. Just stop Zul, I think. Go to my account.
So if we are using the screencast, can we actually like...
Yes. Okay, to use screencast with this in conjunction with this, you first need to create your screencast video first. That's first step. Upload to YouTube link into the H5P. The problem with H5P is because it's a free software and it's developed by developers by donation, it is not allowing us to upload files in there. You can, but it's going to be hard, challenging. Okay. So if you're new, like your new lecturers, it's very good for you all to create content and store it. So eventually after 5 or 10 years, you'll have a huge library. So it's very good for your Anugra Academic Negara.
Yeah,
this is the library you need to create. Actually, I saw them, how they went, like you have seen Prof. Van Zuhainis, from one Zohain is from the from our ministry. She is the Anugrah Academic Negara winner. So what she does, she, her library is huge. She has her own channel and everything. You see, you look for Abdul Karim alias Zul in the Dr. Karim, Prof. Karim, Abdul Karim alias Abdul Karim alias in the YouTube alias Abdul Karim alias. Okay, you go to YouTube. Okay. Go to his channel there. Go to his channel here. Sharan, move there, Sharan. Here, go to his website. Is that his channel? Right. USM channel. You look for his channel there in Abdul Karim, ABD. Just ABD Karim. So this is one of the guru of the TEL in Samahde. So he got 2.21K. How much? 2 point. He's got so many subscribers. But see his videos. His videos are there. Go to his videos. His video. Okay. You can see his videos. Everything is there. All his lecture. So when you go for Anugrah Academy in Negara, this is your portfolio.
So these are the content. Some of them is just not here. Test. So it's some
old. Oh, some of his content. No, this is actually his content. It's his content.
His
not.
Yeah, he's content. Famous name.
Yeah. Oh, all this. Yeah, he's a famous guy. See, with Professor Datu Kasma, he went to SBC. So all this is his content. So he has put upload, I think. Yeah, he comes here. But he's the guru of the e-learning, one of the main big people, yeah. So he has many things, how to become. He conducts the courses also. You can attend his, he has a lot of free courses online, free MOOC courses. You can attend his MOOC. Yeah. Two years ago he had come over. So he has even so many MOOCs he has got. And his views are. They use mostly the flip classroom. They are using flip. Flip classroom means they are teaching the first. They give the content to the student outside the class, and in the class they only do gamification and consultation. So he's good. He knows how to system. So he uses many tools. Okay, so he do. So he even has. He has made very useful. Where do I find free footage for my video project? You can get free video footage. You can just refer. Actually, if you want to get information, you just subscribe to his channel. Lot of information he posts all on the YouTube. Okay? And then the other one is Azida Abu Zidan. You look for Azida. Azida Abu Zidan. Azida. Azida Abu. Abu Zidan. Zidan. There are many Azida Abu Zidan. Okay, Dr. Azida also. Dr. Azida also is. She has a channel, Zul? Ada. But she doesn't publish much, so she is not as much as Dr. Prof. Karim. But she also put a lot of video there. Okay. So if you want to have a chanto, like as model for, you follow these people. They are the one who record their content, their delivery method, their innovation. This is actually innovation they create in teaching and learning. So that is how they do. Okay, Zulu, I think we can close. So we show you how to make the H5P video. Okay. You can do, how do we teach, which is the most common use for, what do you say? What video we find? Video, maybe what is your video you all are familiar with? What is your area like mostly? Remote sensing, okay. We look for remote sensing video because I want to put the question, something relevant to your subject. Find one video on conservation biology or something. Conservation biology. Okay, lecture, Sana Dibawa. Okay, conservation biology, okay. People have made lecture on conservation biology. Oh, 39 minutes, 49 minutes, too big. 1 minute, okay. That's 8 minutes. Okay, there's anything with nice pictures? Go down. Biology. Okay, 3 minutes. Okay, that's a good, that's using the PowToon. Okay, now suppose I have this lecture on conservation biology. which I use from the internet. I'm repurposing content. Okay? This is Audiopedia, also another kind. So you have a conservation biology video in which you have descriptions of conservation biology. Okay? So they have meaning, definition, explanation. So you have three learning points. So your learning object can have the three. So in that video, hopefully, you just let it play, Zul. Let it play. Let the video play. Okay. Let the video play. Because we have to find the interaction point. So first, we need to watch the whole video when you do the H5P. Okay. So for now, we will just. So this is done using a bot. So the lecturer is actually using a bot to convert the voice to text. Okay, so we are having. Okay, so we decide to use this video for our interactive video. Zul, we copy and paste. So we copy the link, go back to H5P, and what you need to select is interactive video. This is the most widely used tool. Okay, you copy and paste. Wait for it to load. Okay, you have to first. Okay, we'll have three sections here, which is to upload the video first, then add the activity, and then do the summary task. Summary task is the summative assessment for that particular video. Okay, so you click the video, and then you add the video. You can upload or you can add, but I suggest don't upload because the system H5P will be slow. YouTube is very fast because using multiple servers. H5P uses only one or two servers. So it doesn't have mirror. Okay, insert. Okay, the video is inside. Wait for it to load. And now you can add the interaction. Okay, this is the interaction. Okay, so now you can see up there is a range of different kind of interactions. Some are just text. For example, you're showing some image here, and then you want to put text pop up. For example, in the video they show pop-up, right? This is the image, and then they show this is a bird in flight. You can actually add the text inside the video itself. So you can click on text, Zul. You can play the video first. Okay, you can add a label for the text, and you can add the text inside the video. Okay, so you can add the text. So this is, for example, just type conservation biology, just random word. Conservation biology, conservation. Then you can click. And then you can click on done. You can click a label, done. Okay. So the word conservation biology will come in over there. So you can see the click. When you click on the link. Okay. You can click. Okay, 1 minute. You need to add the tags. Just the tag. You click on the link. You should see. 1 minute. Add the tag. Go back to the edit. Edit. The edit here. Icon here. Edit. So just add the tag, conservation biology. Just copy and paste the tag. Okay. Should be okay. Done. Okay, so when you move, you see the. So you can see this thing will come. So this is suppose some part is in your video, there is one section, like a section of a bird or a shell or a mountain. You can add that thing and you can move that. You can move it around wherever you want to move. Okay. It'll appear at certain part of the video and disappear. You can set the time, and also the time you can set the masa. So it will appear in the first part of the video. Okay, now we want to add the question. So we go back to the original screen, Zul. Okay, we add the interaction. Now you need to play the video until the point at which you want to add the interaction. Okay, just move forward. Somewhere. Okay. So in the video, we assume that the lecturer, whoever is talking about the conservation biology, move forward. Stick it. Okay, they are talking about conservation. Okay, stop in the middle somewhere, earlier, somewhere, just stop it randomly. Okay, stop. Then you can add your interaction. So you have many type of interaction here. One is the table, but what we use is the multiple choice. So you have here statement, single choice set, multiple choice, true, false. Okay, let's start with the true, false. Okay. Okay, so the label is actually called true, false. You just write true, false. We can write false, and then you can add the question here. So you add the question. conservation biology. Okay, you had conservation biology. This is the true false, right? Conservation biology involves just put dot 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 dot. Okay. So this will actually be the true answer. Okay. So in this, when involves dot dot dot, so they'll be given a choice, true or false. If they click on the true, they will get the. So you have to give the description here, and you do done behavioral setting. You check setting, and then you enable retry, enable show, disable retry, enable show button. Show information dialog, automatically check answer, feedback on correct answer. Okay. So usually this is where you can give the feedback to your student. Oh, congratulations, you got it right. Oh, you got it right. Just click on you got it right. Don't allow them to automatically check answer for true false, because they will know the answer. But for the other one, you can feedback on wrong answer, try again. All these will appear. That's why the first part when you program is actually time consuming, and then and adaptivity. Adaptive. Click on adaptivity. Action on all correct. Seek to no. Action on all don't, and then go down. We just lock it down. So you have to lock. Action on wrong. Seek to require full score. This is the most important one. Require full score for task. Full score for task means they cannot lock. The screen is locked. Okay, done. Done. Save. Save. Okay, we just view it. There are actually many other things which you can add inside. Like you can add a full set of questions. You can set MCQ as well. But I just show you how it works. Okay, so you just do the stop. You just move it forward, little bit back, and then you play. So for this one, you should make sure that your question relates to whatever content is inside the slide. Otherwise, the student will be confused. So it asks you true or false. So it asks you the question true or false. It will ask you a question. Click on that. Sorry. So just click. It should show you. Sorry, 1 minute. It's the system slow. Slow? System slow? Oh, no, just get. You save, right? It's in your video. Here, my account. Is there right somewhere? Oh, it's saved, right? 1 second. Set. The system bit slow, so you have to just excuse us. So just move the point there, tick. True, false. Please complete the question. Okay, just put question. One. A true false question. And you put conservation biology involves the use of so and so. Just put and then you say. Involves, just put dot dot dot. Dot 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 dot. And then you just click. Give it. Done. Just click done. Done. First click done and then we edit. Okay, wait. We edit again. Click there. Question one, you edit it. Because, okay, you want to leave and continue later with this? You all are going? Okay. School time. Yeah, my wife picks up my kids, so I'm free. Question. Click here again. Edit. Because we have to lock the question in. Okay. Involves. True. False. Down. Okay. Correct answer. True. False. Okay. So behavioral setting and adaptivity you should do. You action on wrong. Require that's it. No need anymore. Okay. Yeah. Just tick. So they cannot get. Okay. Done. Okay. Now play. Is that right? Other right? So move it back. Save. Okay. Okay. Just put the conservation. Safe. Okay. Just move the video. Okay, when it reaches there, it should stop. Okay, so it asks you, it'll make a statement, conservation, you have to have the full statement here, and you have to click the answer, true or false. If it is true, you click, check, it will move forward. If you put false, it will, okay, move back, Zul, and click false. Okay, see, yeah. You click false, right? Wait, so. Okay, question, you click question one, click. It'll ask, click false. Oh, you already answered. Oh, it's not allowing you to answer again. It allows you to answer only once, so you'll have to re-watch again. So if it was false, it would ask you to redo the whole thing all over again.